Hi friends, what's up? This is RK from 360 Reader. Right now, I'm going to show how to put your iPhone or iPad into recovery mode and set it up again. For those unfamiliar, recovery mode is known as a nuclear solution, especially when dealing with complex issues. So just in case if your iPhone or iPad is faced with a complex issues and you are unable to solve it using common solutions, then recovery mode is for you. That all being said, let's learn how to enter recovery mode on iPhone and iPad the quick way. Before getting started, make sure you have subscribed our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so that you won't miss any update from 360 Reader. Make sure that your Mac is up to date. If you are using iTunes, make sure you have the latest version of iTunes installed on your Mac or Windows computer. On a Mac with macOS Catalina or later Open Finder, on a Mac with macOS Mojave or earlier, or on a PC, open iTunes. If iTunes is already open, close it and then open it again. Next, keep your device connected and wait until the recovery mode screen appears. On iPhone 8 or later, or iPad without home button, you have to press and quickly release the volume up button, then press and quickly release the volume down button, then you have to hold down the side button or the top button until you see the recovery mode screen. On iPhone 7 and 7 Plus and iPod Touch 7th generation, you have to press and hold the top or side button and volume down buttons at the same time. Keep holding the buttons until you see the recovery mode screen. On iPad with home button and iPhone 6s or earlier, or iPod Touch 6th generation, press and hold the home button and the top or side buttons at the same time. Keep holding the buttons until you see the recovery mode screen. After that, locate your device on your computer. When you see the option to restore or update, choose update option. Your computer will try to reinstall the software without erasing your data. Then wait a while, your computer downloads the software for your device. If the download takes more than 50 minutes and your device exits the recovery mode screen, then you will need to put your device into recovery mode again. After the update or restore completes, set up your device. That's pretty much it. So that's the way you can put your iOS or iPad OS device into recovery mode. Now that you know how this useful feature works, make the most of it to sort out any complex issues faced by your device. If you have found this video helpful, make sure to like and share it, and I'll see you in the next video with more such handy tips and tricks. Till then, stay safe and have a great time. Bye-bye.